Randy Stair, a troubled, dark YouTuber, also known by the online pseudonym Andrew Blaze, shot three of his co-workers at Wise Markets on the night of June 7th, 2017. Let's go behind the crime. At approximately 11 p.m. on that tragic night, Stair arrived at Wise Markets for his late night shift. Before performing his typical store duties, Stair blocked an emergency exit near the building's crew area. Not long after, Stair returned to the crew area and blocked any remaining emergency exits. After securing all the store's exits, including locking the automatic doors located at the entrance, Randy equipped himself with two pistol grip automatic shotguns. Stair prowled the store, killing three co-workers. CCTV footage showed Stair approaching a fourth employee who was oblivious of the horror unfolding due to her having loud music through her headphones. Stair remained watching her back for 5 seconds before walking around to the next aisle. She became aware of the attack when Stair began shooting at store merchandise. The shooting concluded when Stair took his own life. Despite arming himself with two weapons, all fired rounds were ejected from only one of Stair's shotguns. All three victims were tragically killed by shotgun wounds. The autopsy found a large amount of Benadryl, which had been taken by Stair. A search of his home found 7 boxes of 12-gauge shotgun ammunition. I'm Willow, and this is Behind the Crime, where we take a deep dive into the facts around true crime cases. Each like and subscriber helps us out, so hit that button for more from Behind the Crime. Now let's explore 12 disturbing facts of the Randy Stair case.
Number 1. Randy's loneliness.
Although his childhood was prone to some bullying growing up, it was not until high school that he felt like an outcast, a guy who didn't fit into social norms and didn't have friendships.
And high school, I was that typical jaded teenager, you know, just don't want to be here, don't want to do anything. I'm bored with my life, I don't know what to do, I don't know where to go. You know, the typical teenage drama you deal with. And
feeling alone, isolated and depressed, he used YouTube to express himself in comedic and expressive ways. The first of such channels was opened on 9th of June 2008 and was called Pioneers Productions. Almost all the videos made on Pioneers Productions between 2008 and 2009 were deleted. His next video, entitled Mr. Horsehead, featured a character by the same name, which was a toy horse head on a stick. Over the years, the channel introduced 2 more characters, such as the stuffed whale, who was first featured in the video A Whale of a Party, and Froggy, who was a plastic toy frog and was first featured in the video Frogs Are Jerks. Froggy was a toy that Randy found in a shopping cart at Wise one day. The frog was dirty and smelled of cigarettes, so Randy decided to take him home, clean him up, and use him as a character. Other characters, including Chip, were also made. Mr. Horsehead meets Mr. Wooden Alligator managed to get its way onto an episode by popular YouTuber Ray William Johnson, which was viewed by millions. A video uploaded on April 4th, 2012, called Somber, showed Andrew walking around and throwing stones into a body of water, as well as carving something on a rock. There was no talking in the video. Randy himself didn't gain massive success from YouTube, but he did have a small cult following from his later animations he devoted a lot of his free time to. It was on YouTube that Randy managed to feel happy, thanks to the attention he sought through his videos. He made friends and fans, and most importantly, he had a getaway from the depressive world he saw around him.
Number 2. Pioneer Productions Finale.
The final series was a series of 5 videos uploaded onto the Pioneer Productions channel. The first one saw Randy being tied up by Froggy and Whale. The second one, called The Search for Remember, in which Froggy runs away with Randy's laptop and drops it into the water. which is then revealed to be a dream. The third video, called Extinction, is when Randy murders Froggy and then Whale and puts their bodies in a box.
Why are you doing this?
Because she told me to.
The fourth video, called Resurrection, is where Randy feels remorse over murdering the Whale and Froggy. He is then chased by their ghosts. The final video in the series, named Absolution, is where Andy puts the toys in a box and burns the box, appearing to cremate the toys.
Number 3. The Ember Obsessions.
Stair was obsessed with the character Ember McLean from the Danny Phantom cartoon from Nickelodeon. Ember McLean personified a lot of the feelings Randy held. The character was a villainous musician who craved attention and gained power from people chanting her name. In the cartoon, before she died, she was an unpopular high school girl who dreamed of being a rock star. After being stood up and waiting all night, she returned home the next morning to sleep, but succumbed to a house fire. Randy himself felt a connection to the character due to the lack of popularity and loved the song Remember, which the character Ember sung.
Like, if you look on the poster behind me, those were inspired by Ember McLean, which is a ghost from a TV show called Danny Phantom, which started back in 2003, 2004. You know, I was in late elementary school at that time. But this ghost, this woman, always connected with me. But ever since I first saw her, something changed. And it wasn't like I grew up or anything like that. Like, I realized, oh my gosh, I'm attracted to girls and all this. No, it just, something changed. It was like a spark. And it just connected with me, made me feel warm inside, and it felt very familiar, which was strange. It was like I'd seen her before.
It was the character's demise that truly resonated with Randy, who also felt that his death would bring mass attention to himself. In the show, Ember's power is gained from people who say her name, and in her episode, she attempts to gain the power after a worldwide broadcast of the song Remember. Randy's attraction to the character pushed him to want the same notoriety which he would not get from his normal life.
That's when Ember came back into my life. It was in 2013. That was it. From that point forward, she never left my life again, ever.
Number 4. Ember's Ghost Squad.
The final creative venture of Randy's life was Ember's Ghost Squad, which was based on the character of Ember McLean. Randy mainly put his focus on the Ghost Squad tapes, which were recorded before the characters in the series died. Stairs cites one of the characters, Mackenzie West, as being his soulmate. It was here he adopted the name Andrew Blaze. In the years leading up to the massacre, Stairs appeared to fall in love with the character Ember, referring to Ember as if she was real and calling her his queen.
But I'm this close. This close to my baby. Well, Ember was my baby. She's not my baby anymore. She's my queen. Mackenzie's my baby. Mackenzie, baby!
In the sinister uploads, he would speak about joining her in the afterlife and even discuss how he'd become a cartoon character once he'd passed to the other side. In late 2016, Andrew began working on what would be his final video, called Westboro High Massacre Goodbye, which featured Andrew and another Ghost Squad character, Rachel, shooting up a high school, likely based on the one Andrew Blaze went to as a teenager. There has been multiple tape episodes called Conspiring a Massacre, in which Andrew's character in the show and Rachel both conspired to shoot up Westboro High.
Number 5. The Continuation of Ember's Ghost Squad.
Fans of Stair and the Ember's Ghost Squad that he created had attempted to continue his work with the EGS wiki page, social media accounts, and YouTube channels. The continuation group is attempting to use some of Stair's unused scripts, and their work is said to be a spiritual successor to Andrew Blaze, aka Randy Stair. The group said they do not condone violence and that their work is not meant to glorify the wise market shootings. Such disclaimers are shown at the beginning of video titled Andrew Blaze, Jesus of Suburbia, and Andrew Blaze, You're Better Off.
Number 6. Gender Identity.
Spiritually, I'm a woman. I'm a female soul. but I had to live in a man's body to do what I set out to do. That was my soul contract. That was what I was meant to do.
Randy believed he was a woman trapped in a man's body and would often cross-dress when his parents weren't home, according to him in a video. Stair said that when his parents went bowling during the week, he would dress up in woman's clothes.
I was cross-dressing ever since high school. When you guys would go to your bowling leagues, so I would either film a video or I would cross-dress. And that's something I've kept to myself my whole life.
Stair had left a woman's razor hidden in his room. He had once purposely left it out for his parents to find, was shocked when they didn't react at all. Randy said that he believed that there was a female spirit in him trying to get out. He believed that when he died, he would become an animated ghost girl like in his created ghost squad.
And in the squad, like myself, there are people who were guys on Earth that become girls in the ghost squad, which is where I'm going.
Reports following the tragedy of the shooting described Stair wearing some female clothes at the shooting. The coroner also noted gender dysphoria in the autopsy report.
Number 7. Mental health.
Randy Stair was strongly opposed to participating in therapy or seeing a counselor, as he believed that doing so alters who you are. However, based on Stair's claims and disclosures of significant events in his life, his mental health did not seem to be at all stable. Starting from his middle school years, evidence of Randy Stair's disheveled mental state began to emerge. In written stories Stairs had presented to his English teacher, the main characters would almost always end up being involved in some deadly incident that would result in their death. Despite this, Stairs claimed that his work was never questioned by instructors. It was around this time that Randy's fascination with death and the afterlife became an obsession. He was not a worthy cause of concern until Stair entered high school.
I must have wrote like 4 or 5 stories where the character got killed at the end, and I actually turned these in as assignments, and I never got like any like weird looks from the teacher or anything. She was a nice teacher and everything, really great. Yeah, the teacher never like felt concerned or anything. I just remember not getting any feedback in terms of that, so I don't know what she was thinking, but...
Stairs reported that his fascination with death intensified by the time he started school. He began pondering methods to take his own life. On a trip to New York with his family, Randy reported that he contemplated jumping from a skyscraper to his death. In home videos produced by Andy years later, he expressed remorse regarding the decision to not take his life during his teenage years.
When I'm not thinking about YouTube or my family or what I love, I'm always thinking about what happens after you die. I want to do everything I possibly can in life before I'm dead. And that's just a scary thought. It's like everything has to end sometime. I'll be dead one day. You'll be dead one day. It's not good to think about stuff like that. I know this is scary stuff, but it is just weird. And I think about it too much.
It is believed that Randy may have been suffering from untreated depression for many years. It is common for psychosis to occur with severe depression. Although he was undiagnosed, it is widely accepted that based on Stair's statements and reactions in some of his videos, he was in a psychosis where he truly believed that Ember's ghost squad was real and that the characters were communicating with him. An unfortunate case where fantasy and reality completely crossed over.
Number 8. Columbine Obsession.
Randy was said to have become obsessed by the Columbine shootings and attempted to replicate this horror, hoping it would bring him the same level of media attention. Stair owned 3 natural selection shorts referencing one of the Columbine shooters, Eric Harris.
But Eric Harris had a white t-shirt, black text, natural selection. I bought 3 of them, yet none of you knew what it meant, which blew my mind. I didn't want to tell you that, so I kept that under wraps. That's a warning sign.
For the wisest shooting, Stair duct taped the grips of his shotguns, similar to how Eric Harris duct taped the grip of his shotgun as well. Similar to the Columbine shooter's habit of naming their guns, Stair named both of his shotguns, Mackenzie and Rachel, after 2 of his Ember Ghost Squad characters. One of his shotguns was sawed down so it could do more damage, similar to the Columbine shooter's. From 2016 to 2017, Stairs kept a journal which was similar to the journal kept by the Columbine shooters. He also quoted them in several entries, such as when he wrote, "I hate this world." Stair even went so far as to trace over the photo of the Columbine shooter's dead bodies. He then used this drawing in his video, The Westboro High School Massacre. Stair put a propane bomb in his boss's desk, similar to how the Columbine shooters had used propane bombs. Thankfully, in both cases, the bombs did not explode.
Number 9. The availability of guns.
Mass shootings always raise the question of gun control in America. The attention around Columbine, which Randy attempted to emulate, caused a great deal of debate around gun control and even led to some retailers changing their policies. Even though Stair's horrific shooting didn't gain a whole lot of attention, it is still worth asking the question, if guns weren't so easily available to Stair, would this even have happened?
Number 10. Relationship with his father.
In the tape released shortly after his death, Randy couldn't hide his deep vented anger towards his father. Whilst he held some hatred towards his mother too, most of his frustrations came from his dealings with his father. Stories were told of his father constantly berating his son for not finding a full-time job and not meeting expectations his father wanted.
Dad, I can drop f***ing dead. I'm your f***ing kid and you don't know anything about me. You don't know how I truly feel about anything and I can't tell you that stuff. And then all he f***ing seemed to care about was like me getting a full-time job and making money and then trying to move out of the f***ing house and start my own life and all this shit, which I knew I was never gonna do. I don't see why it was such a big f***ing deal, because I was still part-time at the store. I was still making money, you f***ing whore. I was making f***ing money. I wasn't just sitting around doing nothing. I was virtually full-time at the f***ing store as a part-time f***ing worker, you damn f***er. And you make it out to be like I wasn't doing anything with my f***ing life. Kiss my f***ing ass.
The relationship was strained, and it was obvious from these tapes and that Randy's anger and self-loathing came from his father's supposed displeasure from him. Sort of makes sense as to why Randy chose not to express himself outside of the compounds of his room. Randy's room was plastered in My Little Pony, memorabilia, and Ghost Squad artwork. All signs of Randy's expressive interests. But outside of that room, in his daily life, he was just another human.
Number 11. The coin flip.
In April 2017, Randy Stair published a video that told the audience he was going to flip a coin to decide his final fate. If it was heads, Randy suggested that he was going to take his life at home, and if it was tails, Randy suggested that he was going to go ahead with the plan to carry out a mass shooting at the supermarket. The result was tails, and Randy said that this is going to result in the loss of human life other than my own.
Okay, so here's the deal. Got a 1983 quarter right here. You believe in fate? Here's the fate test. I'm gonna flip this 3 times, or the best out of 3, rather, and if it's heads, I'll do it here. If it's tails, supermarket.
Okay, this is it. For all the marbles. Except we're playing for like much more than marbles here.
I can't believe I'm having this come down to a coin flip. The flip of a coin. Here it goes. 1, 2, 3. It's gonna land behind the camera, just to the side.
I can't see it. I see it in the grass, but I can't see it. Tails. That is a tails, folks. Tails. Which means there's going to be a loss of a human life besides my own. Possibly more than one.
That's fate for you.
A number of outlets reported this coin flip as how Randy ultimately decided his fate. However, it is rather doubtful that Randy would have left this decision to chance, considering the planning that had been already put in place, along with his obsession of the Columbine shooting. The YouTube video could have easily been staged by Randy, with the outcome never in doubt. One motivation for this could have been that Randy hoped that the shooting would gain further attention with the discovery of this video and the shock that it had been decided by a flip of a coin. Another reason could have been that Stair was trying to justify his actions. It wasn't his decision to carry out this atrocity. Fate had decided for him. What do you think? Was the coin flip a stage performance? Let me know in the comments below.
Number 12. Warning Signs.
Randy underwent a number of personal tragedies which may have contributed to his depressive state. A friend of his brother had tragically died, and Randy formed a habit of driving past the location of his death each year.
He was in my brother's grade. He's a grade below me, but I've had a class with him before and whatnot, so I knew him. And he died on his way to school in the morning, smashed into a tree, dead on arrival at the hospital. And that was the first time I got messed up. That messed me up.
In early 2013, Randy's basement flooded, and many mementos that he was storing became destroyed. One of Randy's grandparents passed away, and Randy himself was involved in a car accident, which he was unharmed. It appears that around this time, Randy developed a morbid curiosity of death.
Doesn't matter what you do, you're gonna die. You'll end up dead one day. It's like right now. Someone right now is going to sleep. They're gonna wake up tomorrow and be dead. Someone's gonna die tomorrow that just went to sleep. And they don't know that. They're gonna go to sleep now, wake up tomorrow, go into the world, and they're gonna die somehow. Car accident, heart attack, some other supernatural force or whatever. Yeah, just, I think about that a lot too, which is weird. I think about death a lot. And I take no shame in thinking about dying a lot, but I seriously do think about death all the time. And it's not a good thing. Death is not fun to think about. In a way, it's like an escape. For me, it is.
Stairs seemed to have a burning desire to be recognized for his work. However, to his disappointment and frustration, people weren't all that interested in the Ghost Squad that he had created. Even hardcore fans were disturbed by some of the content and turned away from Randy's work.
I just became this evil, dark ghoul. The warning signs were always there. They were there from the beginning.
10 close friends of Stairs reported receiving an email in which he expressed his sorrow of not being able to live up to his own expectations, and that by the time they were reading this, he would be dead. He also said how he was excited to join Ember in the afterlife.
Looking back now, you might realize, geez, I don't know how I missed it. You might just start having flashbacks in your head of certain things, like certain situations where it's like, wow, that was one of them, or that was a warning sign right there.
Following the attack, one of Stair's online friends and YouTuber took to Twitter to share his shock. In 2011, there was a fan of mine who later ended up being my friend. He was brought into a close group of mine through Xbox Live. I could tell he just really wanted some friends to play with. Once I moved, we became a little bit more disconnected. Last night he wrote to me a long note. I found out that he went and shot up a grocery store, killing 3 of his fellow employees before turning the gun on himself. The clues were already over the internet, but I didn't think he would go to these great lengths. Tens of YouTube videos on his channel, now deleted, also showed him discussing his infatuation with death and ways in which he could end his own life. He wrote in his journal and filmed home videos of himself planning the massacre and discussing his thoughts.
14, 13, 12 days away from doing this, you know? This is it. There's a lot on my mind. If you're in my position, you'd have a lot on your mind too. Every day, I have to make count. You know, this is it. Just under 2 weeks to live. You got 2 weeks to live. What do you do? God is forbid, if somebody does see me blocking the exits, they don't know what they'd say. I don't know what I'd say.
In the later stages, Randy began posting photos and videos of him holding guns. Stair was surprised no one had seen the warning signs and done anything about it. It was as if these actions were some sort of cry for help.
I'm gonna be dead.
before next week ends. I'll be dead. Legit dead. Thank you for all the late nights. Thank you for all the live streams. Thank you for all of your support, all of your feedback, no matter how good or bad it was. And I hope I've helped make a difference for you. All right. This is Andrew Blaze signing off for the last time. I'll see some of you soon. Andrew, out.
Thanks for joining me on Behind the Crime. Like and subscribe for more, and I'll see you in the next episode.